So what did ever happen to MTV?
Hmm.
If you're under the age of 30, you may be struggling to understand why I'm even asking that question. For decades now, MTV has been everything but music television. However, there was a time, way back in the early 80s, when MTV was heralded as the new way to both listen to and watch music. And just like on the radio, this 24-hour music network had video DJs, appropriately nicknamed veejays. The original five were, going left to right here, J.J. Jackson, Nina Blackwood, Mark Goodman, Martha Quinn, and Alan Hunter. And they were so cool. I wasn't able to catch the debut of MTV on August 1st, 1981 because my folks didn't want to pony up the cash for cable TV. But I heard about it. And it was the first time that I became aware of a band called The Buggles. Their song, appropriately titled Video Killed the Radio Star, was the very first video played on the fledgling network. Eventually, I was able to talk my parents into subscribing to cable TV by offering to pay for half of the bill. Way back then, I think the package without premium channels was around 20 bucks. It seemed like a lot, especially since we were still operating under that notion that all TV should be free. But in retrospect, that was pretty darn cheap. So this is the device that sat next to our TV in the basement. Sure, it was pretty darn ugly looking, but it was the gateway to the magical world of music television, and I didn't care if it was a pain in the rear to change channels. I wouldn't be changing channels much anyway. My plan was to watch MTV 24/7 and get my money's worth. And you know what? I really did manage to spend most of my waking hours in front of the television, for at least the first few months. So much so that my schoolwork definitely suffered. That said, it was a very small price to pay for the musical education that I got from bands like Yes and The Police. I also felt like I really came to know some new and unique friends like Cyndi Lauper and Michael Jackson. Their videos were so much fun and so creative. At times, they really did feel like little mini-movies, and musicians like Lauper and Jackson became superstars, at least partially because of this new way to share music visually. And MTV would also air concerts on Saturday nights. I still remember when I found out that one of my favorite bands, The Tubes, were on the schedule. I dropped everything and made sure that nothing would get in my way of catching that very special event. And you know what? Fee Wabel and the rest of the band, they did not disappoint. Eventually, music videos became so popular that network television jumped onto the bandwagon. NBC's Friday Night Videos was fun to watch, but I didn't catch it every week. I didn't have to. I could watch videos whenever I wanted on Channel 28. Yep, I still remember the channel number that MTV was on here locally. So getting back to the original VJs, like I said earlier, they were just about as cool as they come. As weird as it is to hear me say this, but thinking to a younger version of me back in the early 80s, what made these folks really special is that I trusted them. It was clear that they loved the music and the artists behind the songs. They seemed authentic. They seemed honest, edgy, but still nice. And yes, I did have a favorite. How could I not? Ms. Martha Quinn was just the best. She had that rocker girl next door look going for her, and I absolutely loved everything about it. And I have to believe that I wasn't the only one. Of all of those original VJs, Martha seemed to really embody the whole idea of music TV. End of the day, whoever hired her, well, I'm sure that they were well compensated for a brilliant casting decision. So here's where things get a bit dicey. I didn't realize it at first. An afternoon game show based on nostalgic entertainment such as music, movies, and TV doesn't sound like a horrible idea. It really doesn't. But it turns out that remote control opened up a Pandora's box for the network programmers at MTV. And before you knew it, a reality show called The Real World debuted on the network, and it was a hit. A big hit. The Real World? It was followed by other similar reality-based shows like Road Rules. And all of a sudden, videos weren't getting played as much. And then the weirdest thing happened. I know, I still can't believe my eyes here. Martha Quinn married Bobby Brady. Okay, not in real life, but in a Brady Bunch spinoff called The Bradys. It was an hour-long version of The Brady Bunch with the gang all grown up, with more drama and less comedy. The show didn't work, but apparently all of the reality shows on MTV, they did. It seemed like everything the network pushed out to the viewing audience was a hit, or at the very least made money back for the network. And then I remember reading an article announcing that music videos would no longer be played on MTV. Sure, you could still watch them on other MTV networks like VH1, but MTV would have none of it. Let's remember what the M stood for, because there is a ton of irony in that announcement. These days, the only time you really see music on MTV is when they broadcast the Video Music Awards, also known as the annual event where Taylor Swift gets a bunch of trophies. And when I want to watch a video, I just go to the same place where I consume most of my entertainment, good old YouTube. Whether you're a band like the Boomtown Rats or a more universally well-known artist like Steve Perry, there's still a place for all of them here on YouTube. Still, I must admit that it isn't quite the same. There was something pretty darn awesome about that steady stream of music videos coming out of my television set. So can anyone name this band? One could argue that MTV was directly responsible for their success, at least initially. I also miss all of those crazy commercials that aired on MTV during those early years. Dorf videos, products by Ron Popeil, and K-Tel music collections come to mind immediately. It's crazy, I know. I didn't ever think that I would miss television commercials. But I do. One thing that I don't miss, however, is Martha Quinn. And that's because she never went away, really. You can catch her on iHeartRadio, both as a DJ and a podcast host. It makes me super happy to see Martha still having great success sharing the music that she loves with her fans. Okay, I guess that's where I'll end it. Let's close with an image from one of my favorite videos of all time, Oh Sherry by Steve Perry. Please share your memories in the comments section, and while you're at it, if you enjoyed this video, please give it a thumbs up. That's how I'll know if I should make more videos like this one. Also, I would be honored if you would consider subscribing to my YouTube channel. I talk about music, movies, and television, mostly from the 50s, 60s, 70s, and 80s. You know, the good stuff. But most importantly, and as always, thank you so much for watching.